Hello everyone and welcome to our channel. In today's video tutorial, I'm gonna show you how to make this easy Christmas stocking. For this project, I'm using Yarn Bee Soft and Sleek Worsted Weight Yarn and a 5.5 mm crochet hook. I will show you the red stocking. For this one, I'm using a beige color and a red color. But also, I want to show you another version. This is where you can use two colors. I used white and a dark red and a sparkly gray. This one is made with Red Heart Super Saver. Let's start. Take your hook and the color that you will use for the toes and start by making a magic ring. Chain 2 and make 11 double crochet into the ring. 1, 2, 3. Close the ring and join with slip stitch into the second chain of initial chain 2. Chain 2 again and make double crochet into the base of initial chain 2. The initial chain 2 is counted as a stitch. Continue making 2 double crochet into each stitch till the end. 1 double crochet, 2 into the same. We are making 2 single crochet into each stitch till the end. Join with slip stitch into the second chain of initial chain 2 again and chain 2. Make 2 double crochet into the next stitch. 1, 2 double crochet into the next. We will repeat the sequence by making double crochet into the next stitch and 2 double crochet into the second stitch. 1, 2. Again, make double crochet into the next stitch and 2 double crochet into the second. Repeat this till the end of the round. When you reach the end of the third round, do not join your round as we will need to change the color. So cut your beige color and take your main color. For me it's red. Make a slip knot. Take your hook again. Insert your hook into the second chain of initial chain 2. Put the loop of the main color on your hook and pull through. This is the invisible change. Then chain 2 and make 1 double crochet into each stitch till the end. Just make double crochet into each stitch, not till the end, but till the last stitch. In the last stitch, we will make 2 double crochet into the last stitch. I reached my last stitch of the round and now make 2 double crochet into the last stitch. 1 double crochet. 2 double crochet, join with slip stitch into the second chain of initial chain 2. In round 5, we are starting by making chain 2 and make 2 double crochet together into the base of initial chain 2. So yarn over, insert your hook into the base, into the stitch, yarn over, pull through. Yarn over, pull through. This is the first double crochet. We are not finishing the first double crochet. We are starting the second. Yarn over, insert it into the stitch. Yarn over, pull through. We have 4 loops. Yarn over, pull through the first 2 loops. And these are the 2 double crochet. Yarn over and pull through the loops. This is the cluster of double crochet 2 together. Chain 1. Skip the next stitch and make cluster stitch, which is 3 double crochet made together into the same stitch. Skip the stitch and make 3 double crochet together. The first double crochet, the second, 3 double crochet and work them together. Chain 1, skip 1 stitch and again make 3 double crochet together or the cluster stitch. 1 double crochet, 2, 3 and work them together. Chain 1, skip 1 stitch and make a cluster of 3 double crochet together. Repeat this till you reach the end of the round. When you reach the end of the round, you will have 2 stitches. You need to make chain 1, skip the next stitch and make double crochet into the last stitch. Join with slip stitch on top of the first stitch, not in the chain, on top of the first stitch. Chain 1 and make single crochet into each stitch and into each chain space, not only on the stitch but into each chain space. So make single crochet on top of the stitch and into the chain space. Repeat this till the end of the round. Just make single crochet into each stitch and chain space. In the end, join with slip stitch on top of the first stitch again. Chain 1 and in round 7 we will make front post double crochet. How we will do it? Yarn over and insert your hook in the middle of the in the middle stitch, around the post of the middle stitch of our cluster stitch which we made in one row below. So insert it from front to back and back to front around the post. This is the middle stitch. Yarn over and pull 3 loops, yarn over, pull through the 2 loops, yarn over and pull through. This is the first front post double crochet. Then skip 1 stitch, skip this stitch and make single crochet into the next stitch. Make front post double crochet in the middle stitch of the cluster again. So yarn over, insert your hook around the post from front to back and back to front, like that. Yarn over and pull through. Yarn over, pull through the 2 loops. Yarn over, pull through. This is the front post double crochet. Skip the next stitch and make single crochet into the next. And again, front post double crochet in the middle stitch of the cluster. Skip 1 stitch and single crochet into the next. Repeat this till the end of the round. In the end of the round, join with slip stitch on top of the first stitch. In round 8, chain 1 and make single crochet into the base of initial chain 1 and continue making single crochet into each stitch till the end. When you reach the last stitch, make 2 single crochet into the last stitch. Round 8, I finished my round 8 and I'm joining by, I forgot to make 2 single crochet. Join with slip stitch on top of the first stitch. And this will be the pattern sequence that we will need to repeat. So you need to repeat round 5 till 8, 3 more times. Let me show you in this piece. This is the round 5 to 8 and you need to repeat it 3 more times, but in the third repeat you need to don't make the 8th round. Finish with round 7 here. So let me get to the point of let me finish my repeat and I will show you how to make the heel. I have finished my repeats and as I said, we repeat rounds 5 to 8 3 more times, but in the first two repeats we repeat rounds 5 to 8 and in the third repeat we are repeating from round 5 till round 7. Now we are starting with the heel. Take your beige color again and attach the beige color. Chain 1, single crochet into the base of initial chain 1 and make single crochet into the next 15 stitches. Chain 1 and turn your work. Make single crochet 2 together. Insert your hook into the first chain, into the very first stitch. Yarn over and turn your work. Insert your hook in the, we are making single crochet 2 together. Insert your hook into the very first stitch, yarn over and pull a loop. Then into the next one, yarn over, pull a loop, yarn over and work them together. Then continue making single crochet till you reach the last 2 stitches. When you reach the last 2, again make single crochet 2 together. Insert into the first stitch, pull a loop, then into the last stitch, pull a loop. And work them together. Chain 1 and turn your work again. We'll continue in decreasing from both sides till we have 6 stitches left. So make single crochet 2 together. Then continue making single crochet into each stitch till you have 2 stitches left. In the last 2 stitches, make single crochet 2 together again. Chain 1, repeat this round, repeat this row till you have 6 stitches left. I finished the first part of the heel. This is the part in which we are making decreases from both sides. This is the last 6th row. In row 7, chain 1, turn your work. And now we will start increasing. Make 2 single crochet into the first stitch. Then continue making single crochet into each stitch till you reach the last stitch. And in the last stitch, make 2 single crochet into the same stitch. Chain 1, turn your work. And make 2 single crochet into the very first stitch. 1, 2, then make single crochet into each stitch till the last stitch. In the last stitch, make 2 single crochet into it. 1, 2. We will repeat this row till we reach in the row which we have 16 stitches. So chain 1, turn your work, 2 single crochet across, in the last stitch make 2 single crochet again. In this row I have 16 stitches, now chain 1 and make single crochet into each stitch till the end. 1, 2, 3, 6, 7. This is how it will look in the end. Now it's time to form the heel. So usually we need to fold it like that and sew both sides to close the heel, and then this is how it will look. So fold your heel, but backwards. Take your loop and just join your rows with slip stitch or single crochet. Insert your hook into the first stitch, then into the first row of the other side and make a slip stitch. Into the next row of the both sides and make a slip stitch. Chain one and cut your yarn. Repeat the same for the other side. You can use a, if you prefer, you can use a tapestry needle as well. Take your main color again, make a slip knot and attach the main color into the first, into the last stitch that we made, the first row of the heel, this one here. And make single crochet, chain one and make single crochet into the next stitch. Then continue making single crochet till you reach the other side of the heel. When you reach the first stitch, just make single crochet into the first stitch of the heel. And continue making single crochet into each stitch over the heel. And join with slip stitch on top of the first stitch. Chain two. And now we are starting to make the same sequence as we did here. So we are making round 5 to 8 and we will repeat them 3 more times. So I'm starting with my cluster. Chain one. Skip one stitch, cluster into the next. Let me finish my repeats and I will see you on the cuff. I finished my repeats. I repeated rounds 5 to 8, 5 more times. And now it's time to start making the cuff. For the cuff, I will use again beige color. So take your beige color, make a slip knot, and put it on your hook, and just change your color. Cut the red color. Now we are starting by making chain 15. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Then make single crochet into the second chain from your hook and continue making single crochet across the chain. Then make a slip stitch into the next two stitches of the stocking. One slip stitch, the second one. Turn your work. This is the first slip stitch, the second, and this is the last single crochet. Go to the last single crochet. You are working into the back loop. This one here. Make sure that your yarn is on your back, not here. And insert your hook into the back loop of the first single crochet. Yarn over and just make a single crochet. Then continue making single crochet into the back loop of each stitch. Chain 1, turn your work again, and make single crochet into the again, this is the back loop, and just make single crochet across. When you reach the bottom again, just make slip stitch into the next two stitches. Turn your work and again skip the slip stitches and insert your hook into the back loop of the first single crochet and just repeat the steps. And this is how it will look. Continue making these single crochet rows till you reach the last stitch here. Let me finish my cuff and I will show you how to join it. I reached the end of my cuff and this is how it should look. It's time to join both sides. So take your loop and turn your cuff and join both sides. Insert your hook into the back loop of the first stitch, then into the first stitch of the other side and make a slip stitch. Then again into the back loop and into the next stitch of the second part. And again. You can use a needle if you prefer, or you can just join it with slip stitch. Depends on you. Fasten off. This is the end result. After we have finished with the cuff, it's time to make the decorative bow, this decorative bow and the hanger. We are starting with the hanger. So take your red color and make a chain of 21, 22. 1, 2, 3, 4, 22. And make double crochet into the fourth chain from your hook. 1, 2, 3, fourth chain from your hook. Continue making double crochet into each stitch till the end, into each chain till the end. When you reach the end, leave a longer tail for sewing and fasten off. Close with chain one and take your tapestry needle. Fold your hanger, take your stocking and stitch it on the back. I'm using it this like that, so I will put it here. If you use it like this on this side, and sew it to the stocking, onto the stocking. For the bow, we are making a long chain. I made 60 chains, and then using your tapestry needle, just insert it on around the cuff. I'm skipping one stitch like this. Two rows, and in every two rows I insert my chain. So this is the final result. I hope that you like this video tutorial and that it was useful for you. If you like this video, subscribe to our channel and ring the bell button so you have a notification whenever we have a new video tutorial for you. See you in the next video. Thanks for watching.